government-led center has opened up a fresh round of lateral recruitments from the private sector and elsewhere into senior posts in the bureaucracy. The UPSC, in its latest ad, has called for applications for 45 mid-level posts in 24 ministries, marking the largest lateral entry exercise since the year 2019. The roles of director, joint secretaries and deputy secretaries will soon be filled up by laterals or professionals. Now, this is a part of Modi government's ambitious plan to infuse fresh talent to further improve the ease of governance. Usually, such posts are manned by officers of the All India Services. That's the IAS, IPPS, IFS and Group A services, among others. But on expected lines, this push by the government to recruit 45 senior level officers through lateral entry mode has triggered a huge political storm, with the India bloc accusing the government of systematically undermining reservation system that safeguards opportunities for marginalized and backward communities in India. Here's how the opposition has reacted.
So far, between 2017 and 21, 52 appointments took place at the same levels through lateral entry, and no SC/ST reservations were adhered to. So there is a conspiracy being hatched by the government and the ruling party to ensure backdoor entry and dilute reservation. Therefore, when Mr. Rahul Gandhi says that out of 90 secretaries of government of India, only 3 belong to the reserved category, he makes a lot of sense, and therefore the concern.
देखिए, नरेंद्र मोदी जी की जो साजिश थी और उन्होंने अपने 10 साल के प्रधानमंत्रित्व के कार्यकाल में जिस तरीके से लेटरल एंट्रीज के द्वारा आरएसएस के लोगों को स्थापित किया स्लीपर सेल के रूप में, वो बात अब किसी से छिपी नहीं है। पूरा देश और देश में खासकर जो पिछड़े हैं, अल्पसंख्यक हैं, जो गरीब हैं, जो SC/ST माइनॉरिटीज के लोग हैं, उन सबको इस बात का जानकारी पूर्ण रूप से हो गया कि वोट तो उनका होता है और उनके वोट के दम पे नरेंद्र मोदी प्रधानमंत्री बनते हैं, लेकिन बैक डोर से जो एंट्री होती है वो आरएसएस के लोगों की होती है।
In fact, viewers, the leader of opposition in the Lok Sabha, Rahul Gandhi, has waded into the lateral entry row. He has accused the government of going on a mission to end reservation. Here are some highlights of what he has actually said. Now, opposition is calling this a strike on reservation. Rahul Gandhi specifically has called it privatization of IAS. This lateral entry issue has become a big one with the opposition. Now, according to Rahul Gandhi, this is a bid to end reservation. It's an attempt by the NDA government to end reservation recruitment via RSS. So perhaps it's some kind of a provision that's being made so that RSS leaders also get to be a part of the bureaucrat system, the bureaucracy. It's an attack on Samvidhan. So very, very scathing attack has come from Rahul Gandhi, and snatching from SC/STs. It's like taking away the rights of SC/STs and other backward classes, and it's being given to other people. It's a robbery of rights of youth. That's the charge by Rahul Gandhi. It's an attack on social justice. In a strongly worded post, this is what he's trying to say. And he's also said that, look at SEBI chief, who is also an example. And he says, and it's an anti-national step. Now, the question that many are asking is that it's not the first time this has happened, viewers. In the NDA era, of course, the process started in 2019, but many argue that something like this, this provision of having lateral entry, was going on during the UPA era as well. There's some breaking update coming in on this story. Samajwadi Party President Akhilesh Yadav has also now entered into this debate. He says the BJP is desperate to end reservation and also wants their officers introduced by the lateral entry so that their friends can swindle illegal funds and flee the country. A very sharp attack coming in from Akhilesh Yadav as well. Let's listen in.
संविधान और आरक्षण पे निगाह है भारतीय जनता पार्टी की। उन्हें जब मौका मिलता है आरक्षण से खिलवाड़ करते हैं, संविधान की कैसे धज्जियां उड़े, कैसे उसमें क्या रास्ता निकाला जाए जिससे अपने लोगों को वो संतुष्ट कर दें या खुश कर दें। तो हो सकता है भारतीय जनता पार्टी किसी नए भ्रष्टाचार की तैयारी कर रही हो और लेटरल एंट्री वाले लोगों से करा करके वो फिर भाग जाएं भारत छोड़ करके।
Let's now go across to my colleague Niyamika joining us on the broadcast for more on this. Niyamika, we are seeing scathing reactions coming in from leaders from various political parties, especially from the India bloc, and all of them are trying to suggest that this is perhaps yet another attempt by the Modi government, by the NDA government, to end reservation. It's going to harm the SCs, STs and the OBC. Any word from the government yet?
Well, indeed, a very strong worded attack has also come on the part of the opposition party leaders, whether it is Rahul Gandhi or Akhilesh Yadav. All of these leaders have come out in open and they have criticized this government's move by saying that this is basically an attempt on the part of the BJP government to attack the constitution, to dilute the reservation system of our country. And that's the only reason why such kind of move has been made by the government of India. As we have also seen that how Rahul Gandhi has made a tweet in this regard in which she has mentioned that privatization of IAS is the new guarantee of the Modi government to end the reservation. So that's a very strong worded tweet which is being made by the leader of opposition in Lok Sabha, as he has also said that this is basically a robbery on the part of the BJP to snatch away the rights of the talented youth of our country, because he has mentioned that basically the BJP wants to include its ideological allies in these key positions within the government of India. And that's the only reason why these 45 posts have been being given by the government of India through lateral entry, as these are going to be occupied by those people who are ideological allies of the BJP. And that's the only reason why they are giving a backdoor entry to such kind of people within the government of India's key positions, whether it is secretaries or joint secretaries. That is not something new, as we have also seen that how the Congress party has been repeatedly making such kind of allegations. But this time it is the other opposition parties who are also coming to the fore, whether it is the Samajwadi party, as Akhilesh Yadav has also said and alleged that it is basically an attempt on the part of the BJP to include the RSS people within the government, and that's the only reason why such kind of key positions are going to be given to these people who are ideological allies of the BJP. So that's a big question which is being raised by the opposition parties, and they are saying that we are going to continue to oppose this move of the government of India.
Right. Niyamika, request you to stay on with us. In fact, the BJP has now hit back at the opposition's claims on the matter. The BJP claims any post will be given on the basis of merit, and the opposition is deliberately trying to politicize this whole matter by bringing in the reservation angle. Listen in.
Naomi fail, Samvidhan sikhata hai, aur 80 saal ka ek vayovriddh समझदार राजनीति को उसको इंडोर्स करता है। ये देश का लोकतंत्र है। The irony of the democracy is a ninth fail teaches the constitution of this country. An 80-year-old experienced politician endorses it. Nowhere it says that we cannot have the lateral entry. The lateral entry is always for the betterment of the country. लेकिन देश के विकास से इनको मतलब नहीं है।
लेटरल एंट्री ना यूपीएससी के माध्यम से हो, विशेषज्ञ निकल करके सामने आए ताकि ज्यादा से ज्यादा पारदर्शिता के आधार पर, गुणवत्ता के आधार पर देश आगे बढ़ सके, इसके लिए एक नवाचार किया गया है और इस नवाचार को सबको स्वीकार करना चाहिए। इसको लेकर के जो लोग राजनीति करने का प्रयास कर रहे हैं वो नहीं चाहते हैं कि किसी प्रकार की गुणवत्ता सामने आए और विशेषज्ञ अलग अलग क्षेत्रों में भर्ती होकर के देश की नीतियों को, देश के कार्यक्रमों को आगे लेकर के जा सके।
Let's now go across to my colleague Mohit Bhatt joining us on the broadcast for more on this. Mohit, now we have seen strong attacks coming in from the Congress party, from the RJD as well. All of them trying to suggest that this is yet another attempt by the Modi government to attack the issue of reservation. But we've been speaking to experts here on Times Now, and they believe that, one, it's not happening for the first time. During the UPA era as well, we have some prominent names, for example, Montek Singh Alu and many others who were appointed, you know, who joined the government through lateral entry.
Well, Well, yes, in fact, and you see, the ads for the 45 posts through Lit will entry has been given out by the government. Now, out of which 10 are for the post of joint secretaries and around 35 are for the post of directors and deputy directors in various ministries. Now, when this Lit will entry was introduced, the government and the BJP stated that you need to have professionals, you need to have technocrats into the service so that their experience in their particular fields could be used by the government in terms of various ministries. Now, ministries like finance, ministry like information and technology, ministries like environment, they need expertise of people who have worked on the field. And perhaps that is why BJP now says that this is why for lateral entry, few of the entries have been invited. Now, the BJP also says that this will not end the reservation system. In fact, they've accused opposition parties of trying to politicize the whole issue. Basically, the BJP says that In all over the world, there are various countries where there is this particular system of lateral entry where you can get the experts in a particular field to work for the government, work with the government for the benefit of people in that particular field. So what's harm in that? While we have seen that the likes of Tejaswi Yadav, Mallikarjun Kharge, Akhilesh Yadav and the opposition parties, they are trying to spin it off and they basically say that the government is trying to end the reservation system by putting this lateral entry post out. Now, they also say that half of these lateral entry posts would have gone to the people belonging to the SC, ST and OBC if it would have been done through UPSC. So clearly we see that how the politics is being played on this particular issue, while the government and the BJP clearly say that you need expertise of technocrats, you need expertise of environmentalists.
Mohit, just interrupting you there, because now Aam Aadmi Party has also reacted on this particular matter. Aam Aadmi Party is also echoing the same sentiment. Let's listen into this reaction coming in from Sanjay Singh.
भारतीय जनता पार्टी पूरे देश में पिछड़ों का, दलितों का, आदिवासियों का आरक्षण खत्म करना चाहती है। ये तो इस देश की जनता का धन्यवाद है कि उन्होंने 240 पर बीजेपी को रोक दिया, वरना तो अब तक आरक्षण और संविधान दोनों खत्म हो गया होता। मैं समझता हूं कि अब इस देश की जनता को समझना होगा और जो पार्टनर इनके साथ में है, वो चाहे TDP हो, JDU हो, RLD हो या फिर चिराग पासवान जी की पार्टी हो, तो इन लोगों को भी सोचना चाहिए क्योंकि ये उसी राजनीति से ऊपर आए हैं।
So there we heard from Sanjay Singh of the Aam Aadmi Party, who also believes that BJP's allies in the NDA like TDP, JDU and LJP must also introspect, as the BJP, according to the India Bloc specifically, wants to end reservation for the same communities whose cause the allies championed. Let's now move on.